In your headlines, TCI is still listed as high risk for COVID-19 by CDC. Ministry meets with executive team of the Ritz-Carlton Resort, and Premier talks terminal benefits for civil servants. Hey there, Turks and Caicos. It's a pleasure to have you join us. I'm Latoya Walken with your Tuesday, November 24th edition of Newswatch. While the TCI successfully made the UK's corridor list, it seems the CDC is not budging when it comes to removing the country from its list of high-risk countries. Here's more in Tuesday's leading story.
Despite COVID numbers' drastic decrease for the TCI in the last month, the country has advanced to the level 4 list by the Centers for Disease Control. Health officials have been working to have the TCI removed from the list of high-risk countries, but it seems the Caribbean's paradise is moving up and not for the better. Newswatch reached out to tourism and health officials in hopes to receive a comment on the matter, but to no avail. However, it is quite baffling that with just 30 cases, the country has advanced to the level 4 list, which advises travelers to avoid travel to these destinations at all cost. St. Lucia's dashboard, which happens to be at 147 active cases as of November 24th, according to their COVID-19response.lc website, is listed as a level 2 country. For level 2, travelers are asked to avoid all non-essential travel to countries under this category. In early November, the Minister of Health, Honorable Edwin Oswood, in one of his health updates, addressed New York State's quarantine order list, stating that the country was making strides toward being removed from that list very soon.
And one of the stipulations to get off those lists is not just the low number of cases, they also look at the number of testing that you're doing. And now with the community testing up and going, and we want to reach a number of about 80 per day. And once we maintain that number, 80 to 100 per day, they would look at that. They look at your testing rate, how much positives you get, you know, per batch, and you see now we are very low. So that is the data that they will be looking at. And once that is satisfied, their standards that they have for their countries, we will be taken off that list. And we are moving in that direction now.
Officials were also proud to announce just last week that the country has now been placed on the United Kingdom's corridor list.
The Turks and Caicos Islands have now been removed off the United Kingdom of Great Britain travel restrictions list. If you go to their website at gov.uk website, you can come down to the section where it says countries, territories, and region on the travel corridor list. And you will see the Turks and Caicos Islands to be added to that travel corridor list of those countries that when persons travel from there do not have to quarantine for 14 days.
The TCI in mid-October had hit a record low in COVID active cases, but has since begun to increase. Community testing has also begun since then, and the country's traveler numbers are definitely growing as we dive into the tourism peak season.
As the year draws to a close, the government has been busy commissioning a number of new community buildings around the Family Islands. Take a look.
Three new buildings were commissioned in the past week in Grand Turk and South Caicos. In Grand Turk, Premier Charlene Carteret Robinson, several government ministers and officials officially reopened the newly renovated building for the Ministry of Education. Earlier this month, staff of the ministry, along with those from the Departments of Education, Youth Affairs and Gender Affairs, relocated to their new location on the government compound. Previously, they were housed at the Franklin Mizzicks building on Church Folly. Another important project that has been in the works for some time is also completed. That is the South Caicos Clinic. That project was commissioned on Monday, along with a new morgue for the islands. Both of those projects were scheduled for completion in September this year. The Wellness Center, again in South Caicos, is also completed and in use. On Monday, Premier Carteret Robinson and government officials attended an official renaming ceremony for the building. The facility is now named in honor of the late Eliza M. Basin, a woman of the soil, whose life embodied community service. Ms. Bason peacefully passed away on January 19, 2018 at her home in South Caicos at the age of 104 years old. Ms. Bason has made outstanding contribution to the island and is known amongst most for her sterling contribution to her church and by extension the Turks and Caicos Islands Baptist Union and the Sir Optimist Club. She served as the first female executive member of the Turks and Caicos Islands Baptist Union and to date is the longest serving recording secretary. For PTV News Watch, I am Delana Isles.
We'll take a quick commercial break now, but do stick around more News Watch when we return.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providence Jollies, Mides Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to News Watch. Last week, Premier Charlene Cartwright Robinson and tourism officials met with representatives of the Ritz-Carlton on the ongoing construction. Here's Delana Isles with that report.
An introductory meeting with senior members of the under-construction Ritz-Carlton Resort in Providence, Yalies, was held with the Premier and government ministers over the last week. In those discussions were the Honorable Vaden Williams, Minister with responsibility for Immigration, Labour and Employment Services, as well as tourism officials. Government says the discussions were fruitful. The meeting was hosted at the office of the Premier with the following Ritz-Carlton executives: Mr. John Hazard, Corey Guess, Roberto Stipa, and Stephen Redcools. The discussions centered primarily on labour and immigration issues as it relates to workers at the resort. Prominent among the discussions were Turks and Caicos labor laws, general pay including required or non-required service charge and distribution, and benefits offered on island. They also looked at medical, dental, and other required and standard insurance provided to employees, pension retirement plan requirements that are offered in the industry to employees, vacation, holiday, and sick leave entitlement. Also discussed was local versus expatriate differences and any potential requirements as it relates to live in or live out, pay and benefits, offer letter, work agreement templates and requirements, retention rate, and partnering with any schools, colleges, vocational institutions that have hospitality or culinary or engineering technical programs to discuss partnerships for internships and offering leadership and development courses. Corey Guess, the multi-property director of human services, reportedly told the government during the meeting that he immediately felt a connection to the Turks and Caicos Islands when he first arrived here in 2019. Guest said they are looking forward to a successful opening of the resort and partnering with the government and the community. Minister Williams, in his remarks, stated that he is very elated about the Ritz-Carlton Resort coming to the TCI next year, as this is a world-renowned hotel brand. The minister is confident that the opening of the resort will create major employment as well as entrepreneurial opportunities for the residents of the Turks and Caicos Islands. The Ritz-Carlton on Providence Yalies is scheduled to open mid-2021, that is, during the spring months. For PTV News Watch, I am Delana Isles.
The Ministry of Health has rolled out the COVID-19 community testing schedule for the month of December. This service continues to be operated on a first-come, first-served basis and is free of cost. Participants are asked to bring a government-issue ID, that's your NIB, driver's license or passport, and a pen to complete registration forms. The public is reminded to maintain physical distance of at least 6 feet and to wear a face covering or mask, covering both the nose and mouth, when visiting any of the facilities. The schedule is as follows. Grand Turk every Wednesday between 2 p.m. and 4 p.m. at the gazebo Pond Street. South Caicos every Wednesday between 9 a.m. and 12 p.m. at the primary health care clinic. North and Middle Caicos every Wednesday between 9 and 12 a.m. at the primary health care clinics Q, Bottle Creek, and Middle Caicos Clinic. Providenciales, the mobile clinic will be parked at the following locations between 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. Friday, December 11th, Downtown Ballpark. Friday, December 18th, Downtown Ballpark. Remember, it's a drive-thru. Please note that any changes to the schedule will be published on the Health Promotion and Advocacy Facebook page and on social media. We'll take a quick break now, but when we return, your weather predictions for Wednesday. More Newswatch when we return.
In order to auto-scan your PTV set-top box, you need to follow these basic steps. Turn on your television and set-top box. Press menu on the remote control. Choose installation and press OK. Enter password, press 0000. Choose auto search and press OK. Go down to start search and press OK. Choose yes and press OK. The box will start searching for channels until process bar reach 100%. Click on exit and data will be saved. Click on exit again to continue enjoying the PTV experience. Thank you for supporting the PTV network.
Partly cloudy skies across the Turks and Caicos Islands. Here's your weather forecast for November 25th, 2020. Starting off in the nation's capital, Grand Turk, on Wednesday. Partly cloudy and windy conditions, high 82, low 77. Winds east at 10 to 20 miles per hour. South Caicos on Wednesday, partly cloudy and windy conditions, high 82, low 76. Winds east-northeast at 15 to 25 miles per hour. North and Middle Caicos on Wednesday, partly to mostly cloudy skies, high 82, low 76. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Parrot and Pine Key on Wednesday, partly cloudy to windy conditions, high 82, low 76. Winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. And finally on Providenciales on Wednesday, partly cloudy and windy conditions, high 82, low 76, winds east-northeast at 10 to 20 miles per hour. Time now for your sunrise and sunset. Sunrise at 6:08 a.m., sunset at 5:06 p.m. And for your high tides and low tides, high tides 3:59 a.m., 4:14 p.m. For your low tides, 10:15 a.m., 10:23 p.m. Time now for your hurricane outlook. For the North Atlantic Caribbean Sea in the Gulf of Mexico, a broad non-tropical area of low pressure located a couple of hundred miles south of Bermuda is producing gale force winds along with showers and thunderstorms to the east of its center as it merges with a frontal system. By late Wednesday or Thursday, the system could become separate from the front, allowing it to possibly develop some subtropical characteristics later this week while it meanders over the central Atlantic. And that's it for your weather forecast and your hurricane outlook. We'll be right back with more Newswatch.
This is a reminder that all PTV service accounts are due on the first day of each month. Accounts should be brought up to date by the 28th of the month to avoid disruption in service. Payments may be made on our office at Stubbs Diamond Plaza, Providenciales, Mighty's Plaza, North Caicos, and Airport Road in South Caicos. Payments may also be made online using Scotiabank, CIBC First Caribbean Bank, and Royal Bank of Canada. Please allow 3 business days for online payments to be processed. We thank you for your cooperation.
Welcome back to Newswatch. Premier Robinson is assuring the Civil Service Association that the government of the Turks and Caicos Islands remain committed to the return of terminal benefits for the public service. Take a look. Reassuring the Civil Service Association that the government of the Turks and Caicos Islands is committed to the return of terminal benefits for the public service, Premier Honorable Charlene Cartwright Robinson stated, quote, "On coming to office, I met with the then president of the CSA and members of the executive. Following that meeting, I also spoke with the deputy governor, who advised that the committee appointed in 2015 had been able to progress the work further due to other pressing commitments. We agreed that a consultant can carry out the task, and I offered to fund it. This offer was accepted, and the consultant was retained." Premier Robinson also noted, since receiving the report, Cabinet has discussed the report and have asked for the options to be costed. Quote, "This matter has not yet been concluded before Cabinet. Until these costs are assessed, TCIG cannot and has not taken a decision. The matter of the pandemic and the resultant economic crisis has been time-consuming and has certainly been a priority, but our commitment has never wavered. We are asking the President and the CSA family to rest assured that this remains a commitment, but also to note, as I publicly state, that the budget for 2021 will be late and will come within a new administration." She further stated, quote, "To project that there should be a sacrifice at this time is premature, or to state that TCIG cannot commit has been mischaracterized," following a release from the President of the CSA. "I believe it is important to clarify by saying that the state of finances in this country and the uncertainty around the finances that exist has seen TCIG seek to borrow to stabilize its cash flow, to meet existing commitments, including high fixed costs like salaries, and will honor commitments made." Premier Robinson further noted, "We remain committed to the public service and have over the years demonstrated this. Since coming to office, civil services has seen the return of increments. The first ever hurricane advance, the return of Christmas advances, new resources in terms of manpower, new and renovated office spaces through purchase existing owned and rented premises, new vehicles. TCIG has also committed the seed monies for a credit union for civil service." She added, quote, "Despite overtures to cut salaries on rising to bring the budget this year, I assure the CSA that TCIG will not take a look at cutting salaries as a response to carry TCIG's finances through what has been a troubling year for the country, but will do as economists advise. TCIG continues to see how it can continue to support the civil service while in active service and continue to look to restore benefits for civil service as they leave." End quote. A look now at another story that made this edition of Newswatch.
Executives at one of the TCI's largest grocery distributors, IGA, have shared that they are not affected by the recall of romaine lettuce issued over the weekend. Officials say their brand of romaine lettuce is the Andy Boy brand. A potential E. coli contamination has placed romaine lettuce on yet another recall list. The company, Dole, made the announcement over the weekend, which is followed by a previous recall not long ago. The two specific packages are the Dole Organic Romaine Hearts 3-pack and Wild Harvest Organic Romaine Hearts. The recall was prompted by a random sample tested by the Michigan Department of Agriculture, which tested positive for E. coli on the produce. The UPC numbers for Dole Organic Romaine Heart 3-pack is UPC 0-71430-90061-1, with harvested dates of October 23, 2020 and October 26, 2020. And Wild Harvest Organic Romaine Hearts with UPC 7-11535-5020-2, with harvested on dates of October 23, 2020 and October 26, 2020. Pathogenic E. coli causes diarrhea, severe stomach cramps, and vomiting. Usually, most people recover within a week, while some illnesses can last longer and become more severe. Stores in at least 15 states in the U.S. are affected by the recall. No related illnesses have been reported to date.
That's all the news we have for you today. Thanks as always for tuning in. Remember, if you would like to see more of our content, you can visit our website at www.ptvatci.com or join us every weekday at 6:30 p.m. for the real news. I'm Latoya Walken signing off this evening. Remember to stay safe and practice social distancing.